All right, what's going on, guys? It is your boy, Synthesize OG. Okay, let's calm down. All right, guys. So today, what I thought we would do is we'd go into some Phantom Forces, and I would show you guys the top three most underrated assault rifles. Or just what I'm thinking about doing is I'm probably gonna make this a series because I did talk about this in the past when I made a video on like the most underrated gun in Phantom Forces or something like that. I made one on the battle rifle, the most underrated battle rifle. But what I thought we would do in the series is we kind of go through each of the categories. Oh, I pressed the wrong thing. Okay. What I thought we would do is we go in through like each of the categories, each of the subcategories, each of the little classes and stuff like that, and we try to find the most underrated guns in those classes. But depending on how many guns there are in each of the subclasses, so for example, like the assault rifle has a lot of guns. I'm thinking we could do either top five or top three, but I'm making this one a top three. Battle rifle, I already did. We did a top one. Carbine, we might do three. I'm not too sure. There are like a decent amount of guns here. Shotgun, my point is like depending on how many guns are in each subcategory, we're gonna do maybe top five, top three, top one. So that's what I'm thinking. Or like for top one would be like the most underrated. So gotta get that clickbait in. You get what I'm saying? So today what I thought we would do is we go through assault rifles, and I have three guns that we're gonna be using for assault rifles. So as you can see, the G36 is gonna be the first one. This gun right here is actually, I'm just gonna get into game. I'm not gonna talk while we're sitting there in the menu. Okay, a lot of people actually were saying in my last underrated video that this gun is actually really, really, really underrated, like nobody uses it, and they're kind of right, because last time I saw somebody use this was like a level 200 maybe like 2 months ago. Like nobody uses this gun. If you use it, like congratulations, like okay, but in my opinion, I don't really see a lot of people using this gun. At least, in the past 2 months, I really haven't seen it. Not that I've been playing PF a lot lately, but actually in the past like week, I've been playing a lot of it. I just haven't been making any videos, but this gun is definitely one of the most, if I could aim, I could show you guys that this is one of the most underrated guns. Okay, so the one thing about this gun is that this one, as well as the assault rifle, as well as the AUG A1, can scope in by pressing T. I'm pretty sure that's T, right? Okay, dude, I don't want to play with Ryan again, dude. I really don't want to. Oh, God. Oh, how did you even get in my server? I put it so that no one can join my game. Yes, I just rage quitted. Are you mad, bro? The door. The door is that way. All right, so right now we're gonna be using the G36. I really do believe that this is definitely one of the most like underrated assault rifles in terms of, I don't know. The damage is pretty decent. I've never really had an issue with this gun. I don't know why I don't really use it often. Is there a third one? I'm pretty sure I saw a third one. Right there. Ooh, easy. What was that, like? Four. Okay, easy quad. I like it. But yeah, this is the G36. It's a really, really good gun. The attachments I've got on it right now is a reflex sight, green laser. I have the reflex sight, the compensator, green laser, and angle grip on it right now. I'm sure you guys can find better attachments and stuff like that, but those are just the ones I'm using right now. The one thing that I do like about the G36 that a lot of guns don't have, I'm pretty sure the only gun that that has it as well, is the AUG A1, is that you're able to scope in like I just did. So if you press T, so like this is it scoped in, and then this is when I press T. So you're able to change it up a little bit. Ooh, that guy was trying to snipe. Ooh. Oof. That is definitely one of the one things that I really, really do enjoy about the G36 is that you're able to scope it in and kind of change the way that you're using the gun in terms of whether you're using like long range or short range or stuff like that. Like right there, I probably shouldn't have been scoped in, but I just kind of forgot right there. But yeah, just by pressing T, you can change it over from long range to short range to long range and stuff like that. So it's really, really useful in terms of different situations. If I can just see right there, I could have used it scoped in, but I didn't. I chose not to. Anyway, yeah, so I really do enjoy the G36. Like, I've been using it for the past week already. Like, I've been, in terms of when I make these top underrated gun videos, I kind of like to use different guns first for like maybe like 3-4 days, and then I kind of make the video on it, because I don't want to like sit there and just have people suggest the guns to me, and then I'm sitting here with like kind of an Ameza, please, 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 please. Why are you spawning everywhere that I go? I just killed you. But yeah, so far the G36 seems to be a really, really good gun. I'm always gonna like the whole changing the perspective of the gun just by pressing T and stuff like that. It just helps you with aiming down sights and stuff like that. Oh, that's a lot of people. If I could just, aim, that'd be nice, dude. Hello there, sir. Ooh, he tried, bro. This gun is definitely underrated for sure. Nobody uses this thing. I don't understand why. Thing is, actually, I'm the only person with kills on my team right now. I'm going 8-0. Like, this gun is really, really, really nice. Like, the, wait, mouse, please, please, mouse. My mouse just glitched out. Oh my God. Why? Oh my gosh, the perks of having two monitors, bro. But yeah, in terms of stability and like aiming down sight and stuff like that, like there's barely any recoil on this gun at all. You guys see me using the Honey Badger a lot and there's quite a bit of recoil on that gun, but I've kind of gotten used to using it and stuff like that. So I like the way the recoil feels on the Honey Badger, probably because, you know, it's one of my favorite guns, even though I'm kind of switching over to the AS Val right now. I never really used to see a lot of people using the AS Val. Okay, okay, please, please, no. I love Phantom Forces, bro! Oh, I messed this up because when I press... See, I told you it, that's clear proof that my mouse just glitched right there. Oh my gosh. And guys, by the way, a lot of you guys do ask me in the comments a lot, like whenever I'm sniping, how come sometimes the thing, ooh, rank 70 and then I die. Him jumping, see, okay, if I wasn't scoped right there, I would have killed him. But like him jumping out of the way right there really messed me up, and the other guy had a gun, but he had a knife and he quickly like changed out. Anyway, a lot of you guys really do ask me a lot about like when I'm sniping and how come it keeps on like scoping in and out. It's not me. Like you can't press T to scope in and out and stuff like that with it. It's a glitch. Did this guy know? Does he know that I jumped down or... Oh, clearly not. Okay. But yeah, no, it's a glitch. I don't do anything to make it, you know, scope in a little bit and then in even more. It's kind of just a glitch. I don't know why it does that. Another bug and glitch that, you know, the devs kind of have to, you know, fix, but they just don't fix it anymore. I don't know when they're going to update the game again. Oof. Yeah, overall thoughts on this gun. I'm not gonna keep, you know, talking about it since I really don't have anything else to say about it. It's really, really good. Definitely underrated. Nobody uses it at all, and it's really powerful. I'm not gonna lie, it was super powerful, actually. All right, so the next gun that I had in mind was the AK-47. But some people use AKs, I'm not gonna lie. Like, a lot of people use the AKM, but I don't really see a lot of people using the AK-47. I really did find that this gun was kind of underrated just because a lot of people don't really use it that often. A lot of people use the AK-47, or not the AK-47. A lot of people use different types of AKs, but I never really see people using the AK-47 often just because it has, like, the most recoil than the rest of all the other AKs. My teammate was right there. Why? But yeah, the AK-47 definitely has the most damage. It does like 42 damage, I'm pretty sure. One of the other AKs does 40 damage, but definitely not like that, not as much as the AK-47. The AK-47 does 42 damage, and it's really, really, really powerful. But yeah, when I use it, I don't usually put a sight on it. I don't know. I kind of just, I enjoy it. You can put a sight on it. There's nothing wrong with that. I just kind of like the feel of it better without a sight. That's just me, though. Oof, right there. Ooh, I love these little slide kills that I'm getting. Wait, that should have been triple. Yeah, that was a triple. I heard so many hit markers on that second guy. There was definitely a guy behind him. But yeah, in terms of the AK-47, it's definitely a really, really underrated gun. A lot of people use AKs in the game, as I said before, but not a lot of people use the AK-47 just because it has a lot of recoil. But if you choose the right attachments and you just kind of get used to the recoil, you can, it literally tears down enemies. Like, look at it, dude. It literally tears down enemies. If you just pinpoint every single bullet onto your enemy, you really should never have a problem with it. Just the recoil might be a little bit much for some people, but if you like the Honey Badger, if you like some guns with recoil, like, I personally like guns with recoil because, like, I'd rather not have a gun without any recoil. But that's just me. Like, I'd like to make the game feel as real as possible. But, you know, obviously it's Roblox. It's Phantom Forces. The game has way too many bugs. It's not going to feel that amazing. I keep hearing footsteps, but, like, I don't know where they're at. Like, I hear footsteps in my headset, and then, like, I kind of turn around. Like, oh, like, right there. I heard that guy right there. That was, like, a nice little slide kill, too. This gun isn't really the best in terms of long distance shooting and stuff like that, but it definitely does really good damage. But, like, then again, I'm not really using a sight on it right now, so I'm not really going to be doing that amazing in terms of range. Ooh, this guy's using an ACOG on an RPK. What the heck? That's different. Okay. But yeah, I'm sure if you kind of get used to the gun, like, every single gun in the game is really, really good if you understand how to use it, and you kind of just, like, you really just have to take the time to understand to use it. Like, everybody usually picks guns like, you know, AUG-A1, things like, I don't know. People usually pick guns with, like, no recoil just because it makes it a lot easier. But, like, funny enough, the guns with the most recoil end up doing the most amount of damage and end up being the better weapons. So I'd rather pick a gun that does a lot of damage and, like, a much more recoil just so I can tear down enemies much faster. Who is this guy over here just tearing down enemies, bro? Who is this guy right here? Excuse me. No. That guy was irritating me. I'm so happy I got him. Jesus Christ. That guy's really good at the game. I like him. He's really, really good. He was just irritating me, dude. All right, but yeah, overall thoughts on the gun. Look at this guy, man. He's good. Okay, bro. Yeah, I like you, dude. Yeah, overthoughts on the AK-47. Really, really good gun. Highest damage in all the assault rifles. Definitely underrated. I think a lot of people should start using it again. And the last gun that I thought that I would put into this little top three underrated assault rifles guns video. Why did I say the whole thing, dude? That was so lame of me. Okay. But yeah, I thought that I would put the AS Val in it just because I never really, just keep in mind, this is also my opinion, guys. It's not really, you know, confirmed or anything like that. Like, this isn't an official, oh, these are definitely the top three most underrated guns. But these are, it's kind of just like my opinion and stuff like that. Just to give you guys an idea of what type of guns that I personally don't really see that often being used in the game. But like, the AS Val is definitely a gun that a lot of people used to use often. And then it got nerfed and then back to being overpowered. And I've really been enjoying it lately. Right now, I got a Coyote. No, I've got a, I usually switch between the Reflex Sight and then whichever, what is this one? This isn't the Coyote. Is it the Coyote? Yeah, this is the Coyote. Right now, I'm using the Coyote Sight with it, and I've got the green. No, I don't have a green laser. I have an extended mag. The extended mag is what really makes this gun unique. The gun, you know, normally only has 20 bullets, and then the extended mag makes it 30. So it really does help a lot in terms of, you know, getting out of sticky situations. Like, I've tested it many, many times using without and with it. And, you know, the extended mag has helped me so much in terms of, like, helping me get out of sticky ass situations, dude. Like, it's honestly one of the best attachments. I wish that a lot of other guns had extended magazines, but then again, the extended magazine for the AS Val just turns it into a regular gun. It's just that you can't put a laser on it, and a lot of people like to use lasers, so that's the only sacrifice that a lot of people have to make whenever using this gun. But I personally don't really mind, because, you know, the laser, it's, as long as I can get the kill and I have enough bullets to get, you know, a triple or a quad kill and stuff like that, it really has never been an issue for me. So I've just been really, really enjoying this gun. You guys might not agree with this as the last most underrated one, but I personally really have been enjoying this gun. It's definitely Honey Badger, you guys already know, has always been my favorite gun, but the AS Val is taking it over right now, dude. Look at this. I'm literally going off right now, dude. This gun is insane. This gun is really good. Every time I get my hands on the AS Val, oh, I go off, bro. I go off. Like, I've already run out of all ammo right there, dude. I'm just gonna, hopefully I can get some. I'm gonna pick up this guy's RPK real quick, because he's been irritating me with this little ACOG scope on this. What is this? Ooh. See, the ACOG scope is good when you're in, like, medium range maps. Like, I would say Rabat, it's really good, but... Oh, and this guy actually has nice attachments with it, too. I don't know what this right here is. Oh, he has this for, so he did a good job making this gun. These things. Not a lot of people really use the Delta sights and things like that, but ooh, I like this. I like this. This guy knows how to play his game, dude. Wow. Okay, yeah, no, he found a really good gun. Found a really good gun, dude. Look at this thing. This thing's a monster. Jesus! This thing's a monster, bro. Oh my god. I like it. Yo, if this guy's watching this video, not saying that, you know, he's watching or anything like that, but if he is, props to him. He found a really good gun, dude. A really good gun and attachments. Like, I'm actually going off right now. What the frick? Oh my god, this thing is crazy. This thing is crazy. I like it. Oh, all right. Well, yeah, 51-7. That was a nice little streak I was going on right there. But yeah, guys, that's basically the video. I'm not really gonna kind of drag it on as much as I already have. I feel like I've been, when I make these types of videos where I have to showcase like a bunch of different guns in like one video, I kind of start like, since I'm so used to playing with one gun throughout the game, I kind of just use it for a long time and then I forget about what the actual video is about. So, you know, that's why I kind of spent a long time on the G36. But yeah, guys, these are the base. Jesus, look at this guy. He's going off, bro. He's using the vertical grip. Wow, I should start using that. I need to kind of go through the different grips and stuff like that, because like, I showed you guys the guns, but you know, I'm sure that there are better attachments that you guys can use that I'm not really using right now. The vertical grip. Ooh, I should go through attachments and kind of go through like the most underrated attachments, because I usually kind of pick the same, like, different. I kind of use the same attachment for all of my guns. So if I kind of made a video on, or if I kind of just went through them and, you know, pick different types of attachments, I feel like I'd kind of find really good guns. Oh my god, how did I kill him? What? Oh no, dude! I was hoping! Oh my god! God damn it, dude. 62-9. I started off that game really bad. I apologize. Oh my god, it just got really dark. It's only like 4 o'clock. What the heck? Jesus. But yeah, guys, those are the top three most underrated assault rifles, in my opinion. Just keep in mind, this isn't my opinion. So don't go disliking just because you know for a fact these are not the most underrated. These are just, in my opinion, the most underrated guns. The AS Val G36, as well as the AK-47. The AK-47 just has a bunch of damage. The AS Val is just, I've been enjoying it a lot. It's definitely, if you're a rusher, try the AS Val. It's really, really good. And then the AK-47. The G36 is just, like, if you're in a long, medium, I think that in terms of medium and long range, it's a really, really good gun. So if you guys want to, you know, if you're not really big on sniping, but you do want to get those long range kills, use the G36. But yeah, those two are the three guns I think are the most underrated. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, definitely be sure to leave it a like. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys think are your top three favorite, or what do you guys think are your top three most underrated assault rifles. And next time I will be doing, I think I'll do scouts or PDWs next time. We'll see. So leave down in the comments below what you guys think are your top three most underrated PDWs, because I want to know. I want to kind of try different ones out because I'm not too sure. But I will be spending some time trying to figure that out. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, definitely make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you guys next video.